for it. We look good together, I can dance well too. Now, if you do the resume, I know exactly what shows you by then, but that's not going to help me. I'll ask you a few more questions. Treat it like an interview. How about we all just relax and...
Thank you.
We all just relax and be ourselves.
Paul San Marco. It's my stage name. My real name is Efren Ramirez. I was born in Spanish Harlem, October 22nd, 1947. And from seeing all those movie musicals, I used to dance around in the street. And I'd get caught all the time. God, it was embarrassing. I mean, I always really wanted to perform. Once my cousin said to me, "You'll never be an actor." I knew she was telling me this because I was such a sissy. I mean, I was terribly effeminate. I always knew I was gay, but that didn't bother me. What bothered me was that I didn't know how to be a boy. One day, I looked at myself in the mirror and said, "You're 14 years old and you're gay. What are you gonna do with your life?" Well, by that time, I was in Cardinal Hayes High School. There were 3,000 boys there. I had no protection anymore. There was no homeroom where I'd be charming and funny with all the tough guys so they'd fight my battles for me. Like when I went to small schools. I liked school, but my grades got really bad because even if I knew the answer to a question, I would never raise my hand because I'd be afraid they'd laugh at me. They'd even whistle at me in the halls. It was awful. Just awful. So finally, I went down to the principal's office and said, "I'm a homosexual." Well, it was a Catholic high school in around 1962, and at the age of 15, you just didn't say that. So he said to me, "Do you want to see a psychologist?" And I did, and he said, "I think you're very well adjusted for your age, and I think you should quit school." So I did. I started working at the Apollo Theater doing 4 shows a week. It was really tacky. The show was going to go to Chicago, so my parents were going to come and say goodbye and drop my luggage off to the theater after the show. Well, we were doing this oriental number, and I looked like Anime Wong. These two great big chrysanthemums on either side of my head and a huge headdress with gold balls hanging all over it. Well, I was going down to the finale and walking past the stage door, and who should I see but my parents. They got there too early. I freaked. I didn't know what to do. So I just thought to myself, "I know. I'll walk past them like all the others, and they'll never even recognize me." So I took a deep breath, and I started down the stairs, and as I passed my mother, I heard her say, "Oh my God." Well, I died, but what could I do? I had to go on for the finale, so I just kept going. After the show, I went back up to my dressing room, and after I finished dressing and taking off my makeup, I went back down, and there they were. All they said to me was, "Please write, take good care of yourself, and eat well." And just as they were leaving, my father, he turned to the producer and said, "Take good care of my son." That was the first time he'd ever called me that.
I'm Valerie Clark. I was born a little child called Alvin of Muffin. Anyway, so the day after I turned 18, I kissed my old folks goodbye and I got on the train with us. Because I want to be a rocket. Oh yeah, let's get one for sure. I heard about the red shoes, and I saw the red shoes. I didn't give a fuck about the red shoes. I wanted to be a rocket because this girl in my hometown, Louise Kringer, had actually got her out and made it as a rocket. But she came home one Christmas, and we gave her a parade. A goddamn parade. I had to tour the freaking bed in the rain for 2 hours. But she got knocked up over Christmas. And then we made it back to Radio City. That was my plan. New York, New York. Except I had one major problem. Seattle was ugly as sin. I was ugly, homey, flat as a pancake, and just really unattractive. Get the picture? Anyway, I got off the bus in my little white shoes, my little white tights, and my little white dress. My long blonde hair, which was natural then. I looked like a fucking nerd. showed up at the music hall and I did my little tech routine, and this man said to me, "Can you do fan kicks?" "Well, sure, I can do fan kicks." And he said, "Oh, okay." And I was like, "Oh, aren't my fan kicks terrific?" I saw what they were hiring. I mean, I had eyes. So I said, "Fuck you, Radio City, and to the Rockets. I'm gonna make it on Broadway." Well, Broadway, same story. I mean, I dance rings around the other girls and find myself in the alley with the other rejects. So I swiped my dance card once after an audition, and on a scale of 10, they gave me a 10 for my dance, which is 3 for my looks.
Let's see. Do you want to know about all the wonderful and exciting things that happened to me in my life, or do you want the truth? Well, to begin with, my name is Robert Charles Joseph Henry Mills III. That's my real name, too. I come from upstate New York in Buffalo. I can't remember the name of the town. I blocked it out. Born March 15, 1950. I come from this quasi-middle-upper or upper-middle-class family-type home. I could never figure out which, but it was real boring. I mean, we had money, but no taste. You know the kind of house, AstroTurf on the patio. Anyways, my father worked for this big corporation, and they used to send him out in the field a lot, to drink. Better that than find him lying on his office floor. But he was okay. I was just a strange one. Real, real strange. I used to love to give these garage recitals, bizarre recitals. This one time, I was doing Frankenstein as a musicale, and I spray painted this kid silver. All over. They had to rush him to the hospital because he had that thing when your pores can't breathe. He lived, because luckily I didn't paint the soles of his feet. And as I grew older, I kept getting stranger and stranger. I used to go down to this busy intersection near my house at rush hour and direct traffic. I just wanted to see if anybody had noticed me. That's when I started breaking into people's houses. Oh, I didn't steal anything. I just rearranged our furniture. Oh, school? You want to hear about school? See, I was the kind of kid that was always getting pushed into the lockers and stuff like that. Not only by the students, but by the teachers too. And I hated sports. Hated sports. And sports were very big, but I didn't make one team. See, I couldn't catch a ball if it had Elmer's glue on it. And wouldn't my father have to be this big ex-football hero? He was so humiliated. He didn't know what to tell his friends. So he told them all I had polio. On Father's Day, I used to limp for him. And my mother kept saying, "If you don't stop setting your brother on fire, we're gonna have to send you away." And I was always thinking of these spectacular ways on how to kill myself. But then I realized, to commit suicide in Buffalo is redundant.
4 foot 10. That's the story of my life. Everyone was my size. Boy, that was great. But then everyone started growing, and I just stayed at 4 foot 10. I used to hope and pray, and I used to hang from a parallel bar by the hour, hoping that I'd grow an inch more. But then I got into dancing, and I wanted to be a prima ballerina. But then I went for cheerleader, and they told me, "No dice, you'll get lost on the kung fu, and then pom-poms, you'll get lost." So the only thing that grew was my desire. It wasn't like I was going to be like Marie Tallchief. I was just this baby peanut on point. But, oh, my last show, I'm 32, and I was playing a 14-year-old brat. Yes, I'm 32, but I don't look it, and I don't knock it either, because I always get a show.
Hi, I'm Gina, Gina Theodore. What exactly are you looking for? I think I'd do a better job of auditioning if I knew exactly what you were after, you know? I mean, I can do anything. Well, not anything, but pretty close. Like, if you wanted flirty and funny, I can do that, or like mean and everything. I can do that too. Or if like you wanted a really sad role, I cry pretty much every day. Like, not for any real reason. I just practice, like practice crying. At home in front of the mirror, I imagine my mom dying, but that usually doesn't work. So then I imagine starving kids in Africa, but that doesn't make me cry either. So then I imagine puppies. Not like hurting puppies or anything, just puppies. I like hate puppies. They're like, "Look at me, I'm so cute." Well, you're not. You're a baby dog. That doesn't automatically make you cute. I think personally, puppies are overrated. I mean, try turning on the TV without seeing a puppy trying to sell you something. So I think the puppies, and that makes me cry. Oh, and I can burp on command.
I'm Sheila Prime. Really? Sarah Rosen Bryant. I was born 1946 in Colorado Springs, Colorado, and I'm going to be turning 30 real soon.
And I'm your dad.
So, what do you want to know about me first?
Well, I wanted to be a prima ballerina.
That light, what color is that? You got anything softer?
Anyway, as I was saying, I wanted to be a prima ballerina, just like my mother. And so my father agreed to give it up.
So, my parents, my mother was raised like a nun. She couldn't even go out, she couldn't even babysit. She had all the scholarships and that to be a dancer, but when she did get married to my father, she didn't pick it up.
Anyway, and then she had me. And she wanted her to be what she wanted to be, and the way she did it was fabulous.
Don't know how she did it?
Oh, how she did it. Well, she took me to go and see all the ballets, and then she gave me her old toe shoes, which she used to fall down the sidewalk in. Oh, my toes, F5! Oh, the red shoes. I wanted to be that lady, that redhead. But they said to me, you can't do that, you have to be 8. At the time, I was only 6. I mean, anything scared me out of my family life. It was, not good.
Where do I begin? When I was really, really little, everyone used to say that they'd turn on the radio and I'd just get up and start dancing. And this man, he came over to my house and he was selling, lessons. He was a terrific salesman, yeah. And he put me up against this like big television set, like one of those perfect sermons. He lifted my foot and he touched it to the back of my leg and he said, this little girl could be a star. And I don't know if it was a look on my face or the fact that he wouldn't let go of my leg, but I saw it. And my mother, she saw how much it meant to me. And God, I used to watch all these shows, what was it called? Every Sunday. It was like church. I was Ed Sullivan. Every Sunday. And God, what was I talking about? Ed Sullivan. Oh, sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm really, really nervous.
My real name is Don Kerr. Kansas City. Kansas. October 20th, 1949. Summer I turned 15. I lied about my age so I can join EGBA. You know, the nightclub unit. Because I can make $60 a week working these strip joints outside of Kansas City. I worked this one club for about 8 weeks straight, and I became real friendly with this stripper. Her name was Lola the Taurus, and I dynamic 24 horse. I mean, she really cooked me. I mean, we did share the only dressing room. And she did a lot of dressing. Anyways, she used to come and pick me up and take me to work nights. And I'd come taking out with my little tuxedo on, and my tap shoes in my hand. And she'd drive down the block in a big pink Cadillac convertible with a smile, with an long red flaming hair in the wind. And the boys on the block saw Lola. They all wanted to know what the story was. And I told them it was this big, hot romance we're having. But actually, she's just going out with the guy.
Maggie Winston, sometimes known as Margaret, Margie, Peggy, all of the above. Whatever, it's real. I was actually born in Cambridge, England, 1950. I don't know what mother and father were for or against, except each other. I mean, I was born to save their marriage, but when my new father came to pick my mother up from the hospital, he said, well, I thought this would help, but I guess not. A few few months later, he left. Anyway, I did have a fantastic fancy life. I used to dance around the living with my arms up like this. My fancy life was that I was an Indian chief. And he'd say, Maggie, would you want to dance? And I'd say, Danny, I would love to dance.
My name's Diana Morales. What means that dancing? Who knows? I have rhythm. I'm so excited to get to perform in high school arts. Anyway, it was the first day of acting class, and the teacher, Mr. Carp.
Oh. Nothing can get a girl transferred to school high. And, I mean, what can I say? I've
Now, do you want us?
Yes, Paul, please, anyone in here? Fine, join the line.
apology sincerely, but I can't. Now, the fallen people, please step forward.